Doesn't like you what? Yeah. Well, for your duck, you're going to grab the head. For the duck this, you're going to grab the head. Right? Yeah. And this is a situation where you don't care. I don't like to hang on the head unless I'm either stalling or just trying to wear that down. Because if you control my elbow here, it's hard to get my arm up, right? But in your case, you don't care if you get your arm up, because you're going to leave it on his head, right? So who cares? But here's the deal. If you can't get your duck, and you're here, and if you need the score, you're going to have to break this hole and start over, because you can't clear your arm, right? But you need the head, you know? And what I would do if I were you is, I'd learn a snap down and go with your duck, or a high crotch, and then. So I'm here, right? This used to be one of my favorite series, actually. Although I never had the duck like you did. I didn't even just get it on my car. But if I get an underhook, you ever have that pulled down on your arm real tight?
Yeah.
So you can't raise the arm, and he like gets real low, and he's strong, so you can't get under him. You ever wrestle somebody like that? It's a perfect guy to snap down. In fact, huh? Lost your arm, right? Wait. I'm gonna pretend I'm going for him. Okay, now it's a lot harder to snap a man down after you grab his head. That's the only thing I'm gonna tell you about grabbing the head is I wouldn't hang on. I just grab it right before you hit your duck. In other words, if you're gonna hit your duck, feel like it's there, I just pop it and then go. But don't leave your arm up here. Come in here if you want. Okay, now. Here's a high crotch off of this. You ever do that? Oh, good. Alright, now, he's bearing down where I can't get any of to come here. Now, go ahead. Put your weight down. Take an outside step. Now, your hand does this. Right there. And step here, and all my weight's going to go right on to his shoulder. Right here. From my stomach. Okay, I step here. Pull the bar with my stomach and throw them down where I'm not anymore. So I'm here, I go, just like that. Okay. Here, pull. See, I'm pulling him down just enough that I can get over his head. And I got the front headlock. Right? Now, be scared of the front headlock. He doesn't like the front headlock, so he stands a little taller. He's tired of that. So then I go, like I'm going to front headlock him again. He brings his head up. I can try to see how they would work together. That's good. That's kind of an idea anyway. And you can also use that same duck to attack a single or a double. For example, with the same steps. If I'm here, this leg way forward. I taught this to Bill Shearer. You probably don't know. Again, look, I'm going to have to get through this arm, so I'm going to do that. Fake. Pop. Okay, now, if he's good and gets his hip back, I end up with a single. If he's not so lucky, I get a double. The only difference was instead of doing this, which you're doing, or this, which I'm doing, you're doing, this is the only difference here. Stick there with that leg way in front. So I can't get to my cross. The only difference is, instead of grabbing it here, I'm grabbing there. Everything else is the same. Just as if I was going to the high cross, my head's right here pushing. I'm trying to get it done. Okay, so then you could have off that one tie, you'd have attacks to either legs and the snap down. Okay, next question. Someone goes over my waist, what do you mean? They want to grab my waist? It's harder because I block them with... rather just like diving at you, he's a jiu-jitsu player. I want to explain that. He's a jiu-jitsu player and they're very good at ground fighting. And they're good after they lose takedowns. But they're not so great at getting takedowns. And they're very primitive about just, this is a jujitsu technique. I'm going to go like this a couple times. And then I go, pop. And we're going to grab you, right? That's easy. Stick your head right in the middle of it. That's what I would do. I use this part of my head, right? And my hand. To hold my hand. Because you don't want to let a man in your body. He'd kill me, right? He'd throw me down. If it was concrete, I would never get to turn my jujitsu. Okay, so he's coming for me, I have to block. So right there. Better picking up a little lower. This region is better. It's easy, just you want to bend at the waist, but people don't understand that fight like this. If a guy's coming for you, there. Got to work out of the walls. But then don't do that too often. You know, especially if they get hit. It's really important, though, that your head's lower than this. If the guy's coming in, I get it happens, but that's the same thing in wrestling. After the Olympics, I couldn't sleep because there was no place on my head that didn't have a bump. Fighting for head position is really important. You want to fight right here. You don't want to do this. Okay? You definitely don't want to be here. Always here. I'm always looking out at the top of my eyes. Not here. If I'm fighting a man, I just want to be even with his head. Right? If you also the soft kick. They're soft, they're soft, they're soft. Really the only real good spots right there. Okay, next. Oh, one other thing. If you guys got a weak hold on it like this, his arms aren't tight. Okay. Any other areas of interest? Anything's free. Leg wrestling, whatever. Yeah. Okay, good question. Brandon, they got their own fancy leg. All right, leg. Are you usually like this or like this? How are you?
Just right.
Yeah. All right, you got a partner?
Because
this applies to him too. I hope you guys don't mind, but because time is so limited, I didn't want to have like just the whole clinic be one hold and have everybody work. Yeah, okay, watch. Yeah. It's not a matter of your arm position. You can ask me how your dress is going to snap left, right? Okay, and it's not a matter of arm position so much. Your arm's already in position to do a snap down. But you can't do a snap down because you're just doing this with your body. Okay, to snap a guy, you have pressure, you have to do this. Right here, see? This is where you can take him. And what I'm doing, I'm cupping the arm. I'm not going to try to pull him down. And I only have to pull you down low enough. Here, that low. Now again, when I'm grabbing the head, I'm not doing this. Okay, guys, get that. Alright, I'm not doing that. My arm stays down. All I want is his head right here on my chest. So I'm just going to cut the air. I'm going to do what she did, fade. Okay, now I'm just going to curve this way. And this is a real extreme example, alright? This isn't how it would happen in a match. Just like that. Feel that?